In this tutorial, I'm going to show you the best settings for the latest tools in Photoshop for cutting out images and removing backgrounds. So let's remove the background. We're going to choose either the object or the quick selection. Doesn't matter which one of these tools. Now, here's the first thing we need to bear in mind. We've got select subject, but we have an option to go to device or cloud. Cloud is going to do much better. Let me quickly show you the difference. So I'm going to choose select subject, and I'm just going to hit Control J to copy that. And you'll see this is the first selection. Now watch this. I'm going to go to the cloud option. Instead of doing that, choose cloud, and then we're going to choose select subject. It's going to take a little bit longer because it's actually going to a network of computers on the Adobe cloud. But if I just hit Control J without doing anything else, look at how much better that selection is. And don't worry, I'll show you in a second how to make that even better. Now, when you're in here, you'll notice that this always defaults to device. If you want to put it on cloud permanently, which I would definitely recommend, go under the preferences. We're going to choose Photoshop preferences. Then you're going to see image processing. Choose that. Now, this is where we can choose either device or cloud. So I'm going to change this to cloud and click OK. Now, when we look under here, the option is going to be chosen as cloud by default, and we can choose device whenever we want. Okay, there's a few buttons we can push to get better selections. Let's go ahead and we're going to choose select subject. And you'll notice it missed that little bit in the seat. You might have noticed that before. So let's just grab our quick selection tool, and I'm just going to quickly go over these areas that we didn't select before. When you're happy with your selection, go up to select and mask. So by default, you might see this. Push the opacity all the way up, and let's look at it against white. Choose the view, and we can also look at this on black. Now you might notice some halos or some fringes or anything like that around there. A couple of other options. If there's a lot of hair, choose refine hair. In this case, we've just got that little bit of hair there, so we're going to grab the refine brush and just drag on there, and that should fix it. The next essential option is choose decontaminate colors. This will fix the edges. When I click that, you might have noticed that some of these edges automatically got better. We're going to output to a new layer with a layer mask. Click OK. And there's our cutout. Okay, so I know this was a simpler image, but the point was not to show you how good I am at making cutouts. What it was to show you the steps and the essential tools that you'll use for any kind of cutout. Now, let me know in the comments underneath if you found this useful and if you learned anything new. And if you're new or you haven't yet hit that subscribe button, do it now. You won't miss any of my tutorials. Turn on notifications and smash that like button into dust. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.